Hopomo, welcome to Disky Talk with Luyolo. If you're tuning in for the very first time, I do ask that you please subscribe and hit that notification bell. If you've been a part of this journey, I hope you thoroughly enjoy this episode. So, on today's episode, I discuss all things Bafana Bafana as Hugo Bruce has announced his 24-man squad that will do battle against Zimbabwe and Ghana, respectively. So he did then cut down that provisional squad. He has now picked his 24-man, which will do battle, and his 24-man, which then will be looking to get Bafana Bafana to the next round of qualification. So then when we have a look at the squad, we'll start with the goalkeepers. So the goalkeepers that is called up, Ronan Williams, Veli Mota, and Bruce. So happy with Ronan Williams and Veli as they've been doing really, really well. Within the DSTV Premiership for their teams, and especially Ronwin, when it comes to the national team, he's led the national team very well, and he's kept a couple of clean sheets as well for the national team. So really, really leading Bafana very well from the back. Veli Mota is a goalkeeper who I must say that I've really been impressed with his performances within the DSTV Premiership, and happy to always see him within the national team. You know, it's just Ronan Williams is doing really well. He's got the clean sheet and he's also the captain of Bafana Bafana. So it makes it very difficult then for Veli Mota to get a starting berth. And then when we move on then to Bruce, this is a goalkeeper who isn't playing for Kaizer Chiefs. So a bit surprised then with his call up, you know. And yeah, I just think it also boils down to the fact that some of the other keepers who are young goalkeepers or who are in their mid-20s aren't playing for their clubs, so then it makes it very difficult to call them up. Moving on then right along into the defense. So within the defenders then we've got Mobi, we've got Jabulo Blom, we've got Sianda Xulu, we've got Rushin Duruk, we've got Njabulo Ngobo, Terence Mashiko, Sifiso Slanti, and Thibang Pete. So having a look at this then, yeah, is this a continuation from the last time? Of course, with the exception of Thibang, who then forms part and parcel of the 24-man squad, which is a very good thing then for him because he has been performing very well. Moving on then right along into the midfielders. When we have a look at the midfielders, we've got Sithole, another player who's been doing very well in Portugal and a deserved call-up for the upcoming qualifiers. And then we've got Thabani Zuke, we've got Ethan Brooks, we've got Tebogo Mokoena, Yusuf Mart, Duduzi Mdantsane, and Keegan Dolly. So very excited then to see Duduzi Mdantsane and Keegan Dolly, especially considering the fact that I've just felt that as the national team, we've lacked that creativity, especially from vertical zone three, from the central pockets of spaces and in the half space as well. So when you have Duduzi Mdantsane and Keegan Dolly, they address the creative issue, you know. So with Duduzi Mdantsane, he is a very versatile player, so he can play as an eight, he can play as a 10. He's a player who can pop up into the right-sided half space, left-sided half space, and then you'd have Keegan Dolly as well. But going to be very interesting to see then if Hugo Bruce would start the pair of them. I know I would, from a creative perspective and a final third penetration perspective, when you need that creativity. Because at times I feel that we've been a bit overly reliant on creativity that just comes solely from the wings, you know. I just think that at times you need a player from central zone three who's well adept then at manipulating the ball from central pockets and looking to penetrate within the final third. So very happy then for those two players who have gone the call up. Also very interesting to see then if Sithole will get his chance within the midfield. And then moving on then right along, having a look at the forwards, we've got Fakhri Lekay, we've got Evidence Makgopa, we've got Victor Letswalo, Percy Tau, Hlongwane, and then Pule Modi. So the new names there, which weren't there in the previous camp, Fakhri Lekay. I think Fakhri Lekay has had very good performances for Cape Town City, and how he's performed then for Cape Town City has then predicated for this call-up. He is a player who also recently scored in the MTN 8 final, and how he plays, you know, I think that he really then gives Bafana Bafana a different dynamic when it comes to playing as a striker, especially considering his speed and his physicality as well, you know. So he can hold up the ball, but what he's very, very good at is then making those runs in behind and stretching the lines. He is a player then that can also come off the wing, whether it is right wing or left wing. So he is a player then that ticks various boxes when it comes then to the final third and what he can do for Bafana Bafana. So very excited then for Fakhri Lekay, because I believe that you can also use him as an impact player. He can also come off the bench and look to make a difference, or rather. And then when you have a look at Persitao, very happy that he's back into the national team. I just think the more quality we have, the more experience we have, the better for us, you know. And at times in the two previous World Cup qualifiers against Ethiopia, home and away, I just felt we lacked a bit of that penetrative play within the final third, and that creativity as well, and a player who's got an eye for goal. And Persitao does bring that by virtue of the fact that he is a goal scorer, and so far so good with Al Ahly, because in his debut game he did score a brace. And then a player that I'm most excited for is Pule Modi, and I say that because this is a player then who's been doing really well for Golden Arrows, especially last season, and within this season he has had a slow start to life. However, he has showed glimpses of why he's such a good player, and I think it's a deserved call-up by virtue of the fact that he offers this Bafana Bafana side so much going forward. And what I like about him then is that with his speed and skill, he's a player then that could look to beat players. He could look then to break into the final third, institute that creative play. And he's a player then that can also score goals. So I really, really like the inclusion of Upule Modi, and seeing him form part and parcel of this Bafana Bafana side, it's going to be very interesting to see then how does Hugo Bruce look to use him, you know. And what I love about his speed and his trickery, he is a player then that you could always use as an impact player as well, or you can start him in the beginning. But when it comes to the left wing, I think Hlongwane has nailed that position. So I think Modi is a player that you could always use as an impact player by virtue of the fact that he's got so much speed and so much skill, you know. And like I did mention, he can get a goal or two for this Bafana Bafana side. However, then when we have a look at how Hugo Bruce would go about things, then in goals, he'll most likely go with Ronan Williams, as he's been the captain for Bafana Bafana. He's kept the clean sheets and he's been performing really, really well. And then when we have a look at the back four, you know, I think he'll continue with the same back four with Mobi, Kulu, Rushin Duruk, and then Mashego. However, from my opinion, I would go with Blom as the right back, as I think that within the DStv Premiership, he's been very consistent and he's been doing very well. It's just at times he's been struggling then to deliver that final quality ball, you know. However, I would go with him at right back, because yeah, I just think that he's been a lot more consistent in comparison to Mobi when I've watched Mobi at Sekukune. So yeah, in my opinion, I would go with Blom. But I think he goes with this this back four by virtue of the fact that when they've played together, they've kept a couple of clean sheets, and they've done very well, especially considering Mobi, Kulu, Daruk, and Williams. As we do know that Mashego came in recently only against Ethiopia, but as a back four, they were very strong against Ethiopia. As the game started growing on, they did start improving, especially in the fullback areas from a defensive perspective. So I think Hugo Bruce carries on with this back four. But now the interesting thing is then in midfield, who does he go with? Because he doesn't have Vala, and Vala is normally his trusted soldier within the heart of midfield as a defensive midfielder. So when we have a look at the midfield, then so many ways you can go about it. And let's have a look. So I think he could go with the double pivot of Yusuf Mart and Mukwena to start things off, especially considering Mart's performance the last time out against Ethiopia and how consistent he has been within the DStv Premiership as well. Could be very interesting then, because like I mentioned, there's a Sithole as well, there's Brooks as well, and then there's Njabulo Roadblock Ngobo, who can also play as a defensive midfielder. So he's got many options within the heart of midfield. However, I'd be looking to go with a double pivot of Mart and Mukwena. And then when we have a look at the third midfielder, it could very well be Brooks, and because he's been an admirer of Brooks, and Brooks has been somewhat a player that he likes fielding. So I think it could potentially be Brooks, but I personally would go with Umduduzi Mdantsane because of his penetrative play and his creativity, especially coming from the central zones, and how then he could look to pop up in the half spaces. So the third midfielder could be Brooks, it could be Mdantsane, you know. Anything is possible then when it comes to Hugo Bruce, as he is a man that is not afraid then to give a new player a debut, especially when it comes to big games and games of importance. And then when we have a look at the front three then, looking at the front three, I think Dolly will start off the right-hand side, as Hugo Bruce has shown that he prefers to go with the wide playmaker, as opposed to having a natural number 10 who then looks to play and institute creative action through vertical zone 3. He prefers a wide playmaker. And then up front, I think you'll potentially go with Makgopa, and then I think it will be Hlongwane coming off the left. But it could also be Letswalo, and players then who could come off the bench. Like I mentioned, there's Pule Modi, and there's Percy Tau as well. Percy Tau is also another one who could look to start within this front three. And if anything, I think this time around it makes things very exciting, because he's got so many options that he could go with. You know, you can start with a Percy Tau off the right-hand side. Maybe you forgo Dolly, or you go with the double pivot. You go with Tau as the number 10. You go with Makgopa or Letswalo. Off the left, you go with Hlongwane. Off the right, you go with Dolly. And off the bench, like I mentioned, there's Brooks, there's Sithole, there's Pule Modi. So many, many options that Hugo Bruce has this time around. And from a qualitative perspective, I think this time around, he's got a bit more quality and he's got a bit more depth that he can work with. Very interesting then to see what he does coming up into the next two World Cup qualifiers. Very crucial that then we go out and we get maximum points in each game, so that we ensure that we qualify for the next round of the World Cup qualifier. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for tuning into yet another special episode of Disky Talk with Luyolo. I hope that you guys have enjoyed this episode. Please do let me know, what do you make of the final squad, the 24-man that Hugo Bruce will be doing battle with against Ghana and Zimbabwe, respectively. Thank you very much for supporting Disky Talk with Luyolo. Signing out.